If you've gone through the previous tutorials on SPM, FSL, and AFNI, you saw how each one lets you visualize the data at several different stages of analysis. For example, you may want to see the functional images before and after co-registration to make sure they are aligned properly with the anatomical image. There is another software package that can be used for visualizing imaging data, especially group-level results, MRIcroGL. The software can visualize virtually any type of medical imaging data, from CAT scans to fMRI, and is a useful tool to have regardless of what analysis software you use. In addition to visualizing images, you will also learn how to convert images from DICOM to NIFTY and organize them into BIDS format. You can then use these with a standardized pre-processing pipeline, such as fMRI prep. We will then see how MRIcroGL can overlay the group level results from the previous tutorials, regardless of what software was used to generate the results. To download MRIcroGL, go to this link, which you can also find in the more info box down below. The software is hosted on the Neuroimaging Tools and Research Collaboratory, or NITRC, and you may need to create an account first in order to download software from the website. The main page includes a sidebar with links to documentation, source code, and a forum for asking questions. Take some time to explore the website. And then when you go back to the main page, notice that there is a section labeled Download Now, with a drop-down menu for different operating systems. In this case, I will select the macOS.dmg file, and then click on the download icon next to it. On the next screen, click I agree, and download the software. After a few moments, it should be in your downloads directory. Click on the file to open it, and then click and drag MRIcroGL to the applications directory. That way, you will be able to search for MRIcroGL with Finder. In my case, I already have it installed, so I'm just going to replace it. Now double-click on the icon to open the program. You should see something like this, but if you don't, you can open it by clicking on File, Open Standard, SPM 152. This is a template brain that you can use to overlay any results that are in MNI space. You should see the brain in three orthogonal views: coronal, sagittal, and axial, and you can resize the window to change the layout. Take some time to click and drag the crosshairs in any of the viewing panes, noting how the other viewing panes are updated as you move the mouse around. You can also rapidly flip through slices in any one of the views by using the mouse wheel. Try also experimenting with the numbers in the boxes next to the darkest and brightest fields. This will change things like the lowest and the highest intensity boundaries for the image. You can also toggle the opacity slider, although this may not make any changes for now. We will cover more of these features in a later tutorial, so don't worry about understanding them fully just yet. For now, play around and try to build some intuition for what the buttons do. Now that you have some familiarity with how to use the software, you will see how to use it to convert DICOM images to NIFTY format. We will cover all of that and more in the next video.